Ladies and gentlemen, you are listening to the Super Spy Podcast. Hang on, because I am going for the throat. Hey, guys. Well, I'll tell you what, I just don't understand what's going on. I'm not one of those guys that follow the Zodiac, so I don't know if maybe my stars aren't aligned. But let me tell you, there's something going on, and I'm checking my life to make sure this isn't one of those karma paybacks, but I really don't believe in karma either. I believe in, you know, doing unto others as I want them to do unto me. And that's why I'm such a nice guy. I want people to treat me nice. That's bottom line. But today, man, it's just been a series of unfortunate events. Matter of fact, for the past week and a half. And let me tell you, we're going to start off with the fact that my Corvette has been in the shop now for 1 week plus. And so today I said, look, guys, I need a car because I do drive a motorcycle, but the rain is getting a little heavy, and I need a car. And I'm thinking they're going to give me something, you know, close to a, you know, my white, Arctic white Corvette. And sure enough, today they let me drive a white Equinox. I'm just hoping no one in town sees me. I'm going to start wearing a mask. But holy smokes, come on. Come on, Chevy dealers. They can't figure out this rattle that's going on in my car. So they actually took a sound bite of what they're hearing and sent it off to GM. And, well, they're trying to explore what's going on. So we will see. Okay, guys? But y'all help me now. Send some good vibes this way. I do covet your prayers, because I am a prayer believer. So, and you know, God don't really care about my car. He cares about my salvation. But it's okay, guys. Look, just give it a try for me, please. Another thing that has me a little miffed is I was going to start this off with a little cowbell, but I cannot find my cowbell. Now, I think my wife may be up to something, like, because she don't really like cowbells. She's not into Southern rock. And we know that it's a requirement to have cowbell for genuine Southern rock. So I'm going to keep looking, but until then... But it's all good. All right, guys. Now I got a little bit of cowbell. I'm feeling better about life. Hey, listen, I do want to give you guys a little bit of cool news here. I woke up in the middle of the night, as is the norm at my age, and I looked at the clock, and yep, 3:15 a.m. And I sit up so that my feet can feel around for my slippers. And then after I slip the feet in there, because they're nice and warm, I had to stand up because, well, quite frankly, at my maturity level, I had to visit the water closet. And look, let's get things straight, okay? As you get older, things change. And let's face reality. We start life wobbling when we walk. We finish life the same way. We start with diapers. We end with Depends. We start with pre-mushed food, and, well, we end with the removal of our teeth before gumming down some mashed potatoes and cautiously sucking the flavor out of little bits of chicken. Hey, we go from strollers to walkers. You know, they wake up in the middle of the night wanting to be breastfed, and now... That's right. It's not a party without some cowbell. So look, don't be shocked. Be aware. But anyway, look, I cautiously wobbled towards the bathroom in the dark. And that's one thing that hasn't changed. Thank God. My night vision is kick butt. Matter of fact, according to my doctor, I am still at 20/20 for distance vision. Now, I do wear some readers as thick as Tina Turner's thighs. But dang, I could see her on stage if I were at her concert. So I finally make it to the water closet and surprise! No, no, not another kidney stone. Although to date, I've gone over 30 of them since 1992. That's right before some of you were even born. But I had a surprising case of YMS. Now I know what you're thinking. What is YMS? Well, for us aging fellas, we call this proud moment the young man's stream. That's right. I had a strong stream of number one, and it felt majestic. I hadn't had a stream like that since 1992. I felt young again. And it was a lasting stream, too. And, of course, knowing that this was a rare occasion, I took advantage of the occasion and was creating shapes in the bowl and knocking down any Klingons. It was just a strong 30 to 45 second stream. Woohoo! And, of course, I wobbled back to the bed after washing my hands, head held high, and had that noticeable 1980s gangster limp. That's right. I went to lay down, and I threw out my back. Anyway, look, the circle of life is real. Now, I'm just going to lay here without the ability to walk for a day or two. Just me, my icy hot, and some Motrin. But hey, seriously, let me get back to this Corvette situation. I appreciate that I've got a service manager that he is on top of things, and he really is trying hard. It's not his fault that they have a system over there for customer service and for the service department that is absolutely inadequate. You know, I went online and I made my appointment. I show up for my appointment and I tell them I got a rattle and I think it's either something in my engine or it could be a catalytic converter. Because I've heard that go out before. And this guy said, hey, super. And I said, okay, I'm just going to wait in here until, you know, they let me know what's going on. And, well, he kind of looked at me uncomfortably. It could have been because I was, you know, wearing my I Love Cher shirt. But he looked at me and said, well, they're not going to look at it for 2 days. And I said, what? He goes, yeah, the appointment's just to drop off the car. And I'm scratching my head, and I was like, why the heck do you have appointment system if you're not going to look at the car for 2 days? So I just looked at him, and he had written down, you know, possible engine problem, and I caught a ride home, and 2 days later, I get a text, and it said, hey, the foreman has listened to your car, took it for a ride, and it's some kind of an engine problem. Now, trust me, and this is where the karma issue comes in. I didn't blow up. I understand that these guys are doing their job as they are taught to do. And so I'm thinking, okay, well, guy, you got to keep me, you know, keep me informed. And he said, I sure will. And he has done that. He has kept me well informed. But here's the deal. I decided I was going to write a letter, an email to the dealership and say, look, this is what's happening. I need my car back because I need to be in Washington, D.C. coming up here very shortly in September. I have to go see an incredible young lady get married. And also, I'm going to stop by the International Spy Museum where they are actually contemplating hosting some of my books. So that's pretty cool because, you know, that's like, you know, I made it to the top, dad, you know, so that's one of those moments. So it's only natural that I would get to Washington, D.C., go to the spy museum with the car, the Corvette that says Super Spy on it, right? How awesome would that be? So I let them know about that in this email. And lo and behold, I received a reply. And it said, hey, one of our sales team will be contacting you to see about your desires for a new car. And are you still interested in the M? Whatever the hell the M is. You can't make this up, guys. If I don't get satisfaction anytime soon, I will be posting my email and their two responses telling me that someone will call me to help me in deciding what car is best for me. Ladies and gentlemen, the super spy is out. Not out of his mind, but out of breath, because this has been one of those weeks. Be safe, America. Don't forget to head to Amazon.com to pick up your copy of Life and Times of Biff Baxter. And look around, browse. You may find something else you want to read, written by Willis Bullard.